So I started my Fearne cosplay just a couple of weeks into the original Exandria Unlimited run. Looking at the art at that time, it was like a very Art Nouveau style, and I really wanted to try and figure a way to get that like soft, drapey, ruffled look that her skirt had. But that really doesn't hold up to weight, to having prop items on it, anything like that. So I started with a fully boned corset. It's actually been long enough now that I'm not entirely sure which pattern I used, but I'm almost positive it was the corset of this one. Either way, any boned corseting pattern is going to work. You can see there's some bunching on the corset after I put on the second layer. I didn't really worry about fixing it because it wasn't going to be visible. If it's not going to be visible in the end product, and you know that for sure, do not sweat yourself over the tiny details. Your time can be spent better. Anyway, after I had this fully finished corset, I started on the sleeves. And so I started with a shirt that I just wear, and I laid it out on the floor and used it to get the idea of sizing I would need for this pattern, and then essentially just created corseted sleeves. So there's the base sleeve shape, and then I made two finished grommeted corset edges, and I attached one to the edge of the sleeve, and I put the other midway into the sleeve. So that way, when they would lace together, there'd be some fabric underneath the laces to act as a backing. I also zigzag stitched in some clear elastic to the top of the sleeve just so it really doesn't slip down on me. And I tried a couple different methods for the flounce on the end of this sleeve until I ended up with just a basic rolled hem. Then I made her corset piece that goes in the middle of the bodice. It's its own separate corset. It has both a lace-up corset section in the back and the corset that is visible in the front. However, the corset that is visible in the front is actually a false corset. It is fully stitched down onto a solid fabric panel, so that way I can keep it looking as nice for aesthetic reasons and not worry about any strain or it unraveling or untying. The portion of the corset actually taking the strain of keeping the garment closed is at the back, hidden under the cape. After I'd made these two items, I went about creating the design for the corset. I'm lucky in that I have a mannequin. There's a lot of great tutorials on how to make your own mannequin, and you can also find them on sale pretty frequently. So I had my finished corset laced onto my mannequin, and then I really just started draping pieces of fabric onto the bodice. There were some things that I knew for sure I wanted, such as the gathered top of the bodice. And then the other pieces are really just pinned where I thought they would look best, and then hand stitched down. Because they're being stitched to a fully finished corset, I didn't have to worry about the structural support behind my flouncy designs because it really was just aesthetic decisions. I didn't like the idea of rolled hems across the entire garment. It would have just gotten messy looking. So with this fabric, I actually burned the edge. This is a tricky thing to do, so if you are not comfortable with it, definitely do not test it on the main garment. Try testing on some scrap materials. The cape was actually probably one of the easiest parts, even though it is really pretty and aesthetic. I've made so many capes at this point that I didn't need to use a pattern. Once I had made the cape and stitched some ribbon to the top edges of this cape to attach it with, I hung that onto my mannequin and just went about gluing the flowers into the bottom edge of the hem, where I think they would look nice based on how it was hanging. If possible, you want to try and decorate it while it is hanging or draping, or at least mark the placement for decorations so that way it doesn't suddenly end up in the wrong position once you put it on your own body. Her necklace and her bracelet, the bow ties, I actually made the bow tie and then fixed it with glue so that it wouldn't budge or unwind. And then there's actually hidden snaps on both the necklace and the bracelet. I recommend that with bows because you do not want to worry about having to make sure the bows are perfectly tied. It becomes a hassle and a struggle making sure like everything's even and it doesn't get tugged one way or the other by a prop. Tie it the way you want it to look and then stitch or glue that into place and find a snap or hook and eye method to attach it with. Anyway, that is Fearne.